Welcome to the general con game. It seems as though a few juveniles with overactive imagination are trying to have a little fun at our expense and are broadcasting subliminally somehow some imagery and scenarios designed to try and traumatize our minds. How about that? And so we have a little fun with them here in the General Con Game. The General Con Game gets its name from General Genghis Khan, where this originally came from was I was seen to go back in history and I was placed in the massacre, was it Urgench, something like that. And after all this and seeing everything there, the general came up to me and said, well, I was reeking of havocness. Came up right up to my face and said, well, you know, well, what do you think? What do you think? And I just said, wow. Wow. I said, what do I think, actually? And so that's sort of evolved into say, well, what should I say to the general? You know, so this is the General Con Game. And a little play on words there. It's C-O-N and K-H-A-N. It seems as though somebody's trying to con the world, trying to stupefy us, trying to shock us, traumatize us, etc. So, again, juveniles with maybe overactive imaginations and don't have anything better to do, kind of trying to dumb up the works here. So what we do is we have a little fun at their expense, you know, that's allowed. And what we do in the General Con Game is we give these responses that are, you know, non sequiturs to what they expect us to say, what Con expects us to say. It's really quite funny and quite fun. Because, you see, they're trying to program our responses. They're trying to get us to respond to their little game, their little fantasy, actually. And yet we respond in some totally different way, and they just like, yeah, scrambled eggs for brains, I guess. So we have a little fun with this, and it's something that everybody can do. They can come up with their own response, come up with their own responses. There are really endless responses that are possible in the General Con Game. And the more you go work at it, the more you'll find, like, hey, you know, I'm not bound. I don't have to respond to what someone else tells me I'm supposed to be experiencing or perceiving. You know, you can start off with, what do I think? And you can say, what do I think about what? What do I think about what? Is that something I'm supposed to be thinking about? I don't know. And you go from there. No matter what the scenery is like, and what they do is they pretty much decorate the scenery and corpses and brutality, terrible stuff. But you know, you don't have to see that. You don't have to respond to that. That doesn't have to be what you want to focus on at all. Just because they ask you, what do you think about it, you don't have to respond. I had this dream or imagery today of someone gave me this door. It was like very special. And here you go. You've got it. Now you've got the answer. And it had this combination lock on it. And I said, wow. Now, if I open this up, I would be free, I'd be happy, but it's got a combination lock on it. And then I said, well, wait a minute, I don't have to see a combination lock on there, I can just have it disappear. And then just suddenly, boom, the lock just disappeared, you see? I said, oh, there's no lock, I don't have to worry about picking the lock or what the combination is or anything. It's that simple. So, we don't want to be trapped in the silliness that's going on in this world, really, and it's quite a bit of silliness. We don't want to go down that bizarre, eccentric road, and so we're just sort of settling back into normalcy, where when we see this locking what we need, supposedly, or want, we see, oh, gee, guess what, lock? You just disappeared. And no problem. No problem at all. So let's see if we can't work through some of this general con game. It's an ongoing thing, and have some fun with it, you know? So the general comes up to me, and it comes up to you, comes up to me, and says, yeah, so what do you think? I said, General, I'm sure you know what my position is on method acting. I'm sure you've read the several published articles on that. And it quickly devolves into some sort of bovine, stomatical compartmentalization where the audience isn't really allowed to digest it. You know, and it just ends up as flatulence. So my advice to you is Meisner. Try Meisner out, okay? I think you'd be able to make the switch. All right, and it's gonna help your focus out quite a bit, I would say. Well, the only thing I would say, General, is that sometimes we can try too hard, you know? So I would just say, just back off a little bit, be yourself. Be yourself, be who you are, and just let it happen. Just let it happen, okay? Don't try to force it, General. It just doesn't quite work. General, if I were you, the way that you're going, I would play the lotto today. I mean, it's the one up to the $350 million, man. Go in there and get a ticket, man. It's your day. General, I hate to tell you this, but I gotta tell you this. The camera wasn't rolling. The cameraman, I don't know what happened, but we didn't get it on film. We didn't get it on film. So, you know, it's just one of those things. It happens, and I'm sorry it happened to you, General, this time, but we're going to need to do it again. Yeah, just roll with it, baby. Just roll with it, man. It's acting, you know, it's what happens. Well, the planning was great, General. Planning was great, but the execution got a little bit to be desired, right? You understand what I'm saying, right? It's not a criticism. I'm not trying to be critical. I'm not trying to be negative. This is just, you know, how I see it. Well, General, you know, in situations like this, what I do is I fall back on what would Jesus say? What would Jesus say? And so I just give that some thought, and give it a try. What would Jesus say? What would Jesus say? Well, General, I mean, the budget is getting tighter, and I think it sort of lacks a storyline, and so I think we need to tighten things up and be a little more engaged, a little more inspiration. And, you know, I can't promise you anything, General, at this point, actually. Whoa! Look at that, General. Look at that. Double rainbow. You know, General, that's only the second time in my life that I've seen a double rainbow. And the first time, it ended up rough. I mean, I'm not even going to get into it, what happened. But I'll tell you this, General. You are not going to believe what happens next. Really. I tell you, General, I'm looking for a little more originality, okay? A little more originality. We've seen this before, right? We've seen this before, and I want to be inspired, General. I want to feel inspiration, okay? You understand what I'm saying, right? Okay. I mean, I feel like the lighting left something to be desired, General. Lack of contrast. I like to see cleaner lines, more contrast there, and the shadows, you know, shadows are very important, General. So, yeah, lighting's important. Can't forget about that. But it kind of reminds me, General, of Super Bowl number, 49. I think it was 49. You know, the kind of the bad play call at the end, kind of ruined the whole thing. That's what it kind of reminds me of. General, I'm sorry to inform you of this, but you have tested positive for performance-enhancing drugs, and we are going to have to strip you of all your medals.
Yeah.
General, what were you before you were born? I want you to think about this. I want you to give it a lot of consideration. What were you before you were born? Okay, and don't answer that. Don't answer it. Don't intellectualize it. Just let it sit there and marinate and get back to me on that, okay? What do I think, General? Actually, General, this might sound silly, but it reminds me of ice cream. It really does remind me of ice cream. But, of course, everything reminds me of ice cream, so I wouldn't make too much of that if I were you. Well, I think you should take this act to Vegas right away. Two times a night, two shows a night, okay? And don't let them overwork you. Get it in your contract that you get at least a month off each year, because if you don't do that, they're gonna overwork you there. What do I think, General? I'm hearing Beethoven's Fifth. You know, the radiant pulsation, the cascading shadows leading us into the, you know, infinite plenitude that is beyond, and where joy meets grief. This what I'm hearing, man. Wow. Beethoven's Fifth. See? Water meets land, meets sky. Bones turn into daisies. What I tell you, General, I think you should have made that last putt. I think it's gonna haunt you for a long time. And you're gonna regret not making that last putt. That's what I wanna tell you. General, don't give up on yourself, General. This life isn't exactly a bed of roses or anything. Into everyone's life, a little rain must fall. It's gonna rain on your parade sometimes. That's no reason to get too discouraged. So you too, General, are a precious child of God, so don't give up on yourself. Hey, you gotta cowboy up, General. You gotta own the shadow, man. You gotta face the man in the mirror, man. There ain't no way to get past that, brother. Cowboy up. Well, my first diagnosis, General, was severe affective disorder, a dissociative schizophrenia with a very aggressive displaced Oedipus complex. But upon further review, I'm thinking that it's probably a very severe zinc deficiency. And I would highly suggest that you start eating some kale, actually. And you know what? Kale is trending right now, General. So give it a try.
So she dumped you, General. So not the first guy that's been dumped. Other loves will come along, General. It's not the end of the world. Look at it that way.
Smile. Let me see that smile, General. Go on. Hey, let me see. Come on. See that smile? That's right. Everybody's got some gift. Everybody's got some talent, General. And it's just a matter of getting to it and letting it out and expressing it and feeling free to express what's in you, what you are. Just let it out. I want my 10%, General. Now. I want it now. Now. I think you've got the winning ticket, General. Won the lottery. You got your ticket. Where's your ticket? Where's it? Where'd you put it? Where'd you put your ticket? You got the winning numbers. You won it all, baby. Where's your ticket? What'd you do with it? Did you give it to somebody? What happened to your ticket, man? Hey, come on. Where's your ticket? Put it in your... Here? What? Where is it? Where's your ticket? You know, I've seen this before. It reminds me of something I've seen before. It was just right on the tip of my tongue. I can't. You know, you get that something that and you just, you know what it is, and it's right on the tip of your tongue, and you just can't remember what it is. Yeah, just give me a moment, General. This is right there. I've seen this before. I know I've seen it before. Right there. Spit it on me. It's right there. Can't remember exactly where I've seen this before. Well, you know, General, it's a big, big, big world out there. Really. You gotta, you should get out sometime and check it out. And beyond that, there's even more, but yeah, I can't really talk about that right now. Well, you know, General, there's a lot of things I noticed, actually, a lot of little things, but I'm a perfectionist, that's just my personality, but lots of little stuff I noticed. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. I say that every time I get nervous. My mom taught me to do that. It's the second decade and the second year, General, and the fourth month and the tenth day. You take the two and the two and you get the four. You take the four and the four and you get the eight. Then you take the ten and subtract the eight from the 10, and it brings you back to 2, back to the deck, the 2 where we started. And so what this signifies, General, is something cyclic in nature, something that is repeating like this, you see. So it's very interesting. Well, General, being somewhat of an expert on these types of things, I just want to ask you one question. Why didn't you come in from the west? You came in from the east, why didn't you come in from the west, okay? This is what I would tactically, this is the question I put to you. How do I feel? General, we're here to talk about your feelings. How do you feel about it? I'm here to listen. I'm here as a friend. How do you feel? What are your feelings, General? Reminds me of Dresden, actually, and we just kind of wandered into this open cafe there, and we just sat there, had just coffee, baguettes, and just sort of let the day just sort of drift away. Yeah. I think the way you're going, General, right now, you could very well be a candidate for gout. Kind of meat that you're eating, kind of game that you're eating. So what I would do is I'd slip some fiber into your diet. I also try to get flax seeds, chia seeds, goji berries, and make sure you eat more apricots. And stay away from food that is too gamey, because that's going to give you a bad case of the gout. And let me tell you, you don't want the gout, General. Believe me. Well, the graphics were good, but I thought the soundtrack was a bit turgid. And there's some other stuff I could mention, but I think that's enough. Actually, General, to be perfectly honest with you, I kind of lost interest kind of early on. But, you know, I got the attention span of a squirrel. So, you know, don't take it personally or anything. I found myself, I was actually... To be perfectly honest, I was thinking about my golf game. You know, I kind of got the yips a little bit, my chipping. And I was thinking of, you know, doing a different grind on my wedge. You know, it might help. It might help. I think I got a little bit too much bounce. I think that's why I'm sculling it. And, it's worth a try. You know, I'll give it a try. It actually reminds me of Dzogchen. It does remind me of Dzogchen. It's like everything is just spontaneously arising and subsiding, just like that, just like that, yeah, wow. Well, I really haven't thought about it that much, General, you know, but I'm not that deep of a guy.
Really?
I mean, it's something that I might be a little superficial at times, you know, and so I can just, like, I don't really have a reaction at all. It's just kind of, maybe that's a fault of mine. I don't know. Maybe I should work on it or something. And, you know, I've tried. Actually, I've tried a little bit, but I'm still kind of, sort of, I guess you'd say, sort of a shallow kind of guy. Well, General, actually, it reminds me of a movie that I saw. I can't quite remember the title of the movie, but I do remember that I saw it at a drive-in. You know, and I think it may have been the last movie I ever saw at a drive-in. Whatever happened to drive-ins, anyway, General? I mean, it's like, you ever see them anymore? Yeah, they used to be all over the place. I don't even know what happened to them. Well, I'd give it a 4. And I give it a 4 only because I feel you have much more in you. And you need to really dig deep for that. And I want to leave a lot of room for you to grow, General. Really. I mean, for me, growth is very important. And this is what I want to encourage. Just, you know, just take it to heart and see where it takes you.
What do I think?
General, you're not a hopeless case. You really are not. I mean, you might think you are, but I'm telling you right now, I have cured quite a few who are way worse off than you are. Way worse off, and they all thought they were incurable, you know. This is the thing. This is the way the ego works. I am incurable, you know. But look, you get into therapy, and you'll be amazed how easy it is, actually, to turn this around, and you actually will see that you're not a hopeless case at all. Well, it's going to take some time, you know, but like fine wine, it takes time. It gets better with time. The really good stuff that's worth doing, it takes some time. But you're going to find out, General, it's time well spent. Well, I think the script was flawed from the very beginning. That you didn't even have a chance, actually, to succeed. It's a bad script. And so we gotta rewrite the script. Before we do anything else, you gotta build from the foundation, General. Okay? So we're gonna rewrite that script and see where that takes us. Well, you understand, General, that one must have a certain background. We can't just let anyone in. I mean, we do have certain standards we must uphold. I'm sure you understand, General. Sorry, General. Well, what I'm most interested in, General, is what were your dreams like a couple nights ago? Any nightmares? Were you woken up? Did anything in particular you remember about your dreams in the last couple nights, two or three nights? This is very important. If you can just try to think back about your dreams and anything come up that was startling in any way, or kind of eccentric, or just kind of, you said, wow, what is that? So if you could remember, it'd be very helpful for me. You know, General, if we could just harness all that energy and initiative that you show and just turn it in the right direction, we could get this world humming. It is all we need is we need to use the human potential and free the human potential and turn it to good use. And we can't be stopped. The sky is the limit. You've read Chardin, right? And in there he talks about, you know what he talks about in there. And what was I saying? Yeah. Sometimes I think that winning and losing are really the same thing, you know. And it's like when you look at it, just like, wow, it's all like a theater of the absurd. Well, I mean, you expended a lot of capital, and then you got to look at the return. And sometimes you're only focused on wow, the return, and you're not thinking about how much capital you actually expended. So I think you need to look at it from more of a business perspective, and ask yourself, this wasn't some sort of Pyrrhic victory. you know, where the actual amount of capital expenditure, you know, was excessive to the return that, you know, you acquired, and, you know, start looking at it from that perspective. I think that might help you. What I think is it's a lot of effort to no avail. I mean, why? Why is the question? Well, I don't want to demoralize you at all, General, but from a clinical standpoint, what we would call this is regressive. And there's other terms we could call it too, if you want to pursue this further. You know, the only thing this in general was the peanuts and the popcorn and the cotton candy and the beer and the hot dogs and all that, you know. I was thinking like you could like put vendors, you know, hey, peanuts, get your peanuts, hey, hot dog, get your hot dog, cold beer here, you know. Yeah, you know, that'd be awesome. Awesome. Well, I don't think we can say very much right at this point, General. I think first we need to review the film, and me and my coaching staff are going to go over that. And I think we'll know a lot better in the next couple days, you know, after we see exactly what happened. Did you get any aerials? That's what I want to know. Did you get the aerials of this? You didn't get the aerials? Oh, come on. That's what you need. I mean, that's what it's all about. You need the aerial shots. That really tells the story, General. What I feel like, General, right now is pancakes. I mean, I could really use some pancakes. You got an IHOP around here or somewhere? This is just, I mean, butter, syrup, you know, it's just, yeah. Actually, I was humming this song, you know, take it easy, don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy, lighten up while you still can, don't even try to understand, just open up and something, go something like that, you know, that was going through my head. Well, I think we need to do an environmental impact study of this, Joe. I mean, I see a lot of things that potentially could have quite a bit of impact on the environment here. And, you know, this is something we take seriously. Sorry, Jim. Did I miss something? I think I dozed off. What did I miss? Problem is, General, that I can't really recall what happened because I've got some kind of spiritual Alzheimer's sort of thing. So, you know, I hate to tell you that I don't really remember what happened. You just gotta love it as it is, man. You just gotta love it as it is. And that's the only way, you know, to release it. Just love it as it is. That's the easy way. It's the easy way. John 2:14, General. John 2:14. Check it out. I think it can be very helpful. It looks like the cake that my aunt once baked for me. You got all these miniature marshmallows, and she put them on top and put some chocolate syrup on it, you know, and just like melted them all down like that. It's just like, this is incredible. Well, I think they could maintain these roads a little better for starters. You know, I mean, we're not camels out here, okay? That's something to think about. Sometimes, General, when I start thinking, I end up thinking too much. And when I end up thinking too much, I end up doing too much. And when I end up doing too much, I end up asking too many questions. And when I ask too many questions, nobody likes me, and that bothers me. Well, I would say it's a little bit of Salvador Dali, and mixed in with a little bit of Picasso in his dyspeptic period, which lasted about 5 years. But if you've got one of those paintings, man, what's it worth now? I mean, wow. You know what I think, General, actually, is that I think the Grave Diggers Union has been bribing you a little bit, slipping a little something under the table, maybe. You know? I'm gonna have to have a talk with those guys, you know. Yeah, keep doing stuff like that. Well, I would say, General, that all politics are spiritual politics. And when you boil all the spiritual politics down, what you got, John? You got guilt. And when you got guilt, you got conflict, you got projection. And when you got projection, you end up in a hallucinatory realm, is what actually happens. Okay? But don't worry about it. Don't hate yourself for it. It's okay. It's just where you're at right now. So accept yourself where you're at right now. And that's the start. That's the start of healing the mind from the split, the projection, the guilt, all of it. And then keep in mind that hallucinations don't affect what you are. Well, actually, General, I do have a confession that I need to make to you, and it's not easy for me to say this, but since you asked, you know, I got this little problem with this. Actually, General, I can't see bodies. I'm unable to see bodies, because it's just the way that I am. I mean, I'm literally unable to see bodies. And it's a... Yeah. What can I say? One of those things. Well, obviously in the war, with sulfur undertones, say in the middle, buried with top notes, acidic top notes. I'm just working on the appellation in the year right now, but I've narrowed it down, and I think we're gonna have several really nice choices. I remember, General, in the old days, we really not take care of business, and I'm telling you, in these days, it's like, you know, it's no big deal. I don't even know what the younger generation is coming to. I mean, it's just like, wow. I don't know what the world's coming to, actually. If I had a dollar for every time I've been asked that question, what do I think, General? I'd be a millionaire. But as it is right now, I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger, walking through this valley of sin on a pilgrimage back to the Lord. You know, and I've been a prodigal son, I've been a sinner, and I'm not ashamed to tell you that I have been a sinner. In fact, I am a sinner. But that isn't keeping me from my pilgrimage to the Lord, General. It's a beautiful thing, actually. Well, it's not so much what I think, General, but it's what I see. And I see God. That is what I see. Everything is just God, and God. Hello, God. Hello, God. Hello, God. Everyone I meet is God. Everywhere I go is God. It's just God. You know, it's just like, wow. I met this guru in India, General. And what this guru told me, blew my mind. Actually, what this guru said was, you don't always know what you're doing and how you're doing until you've done it. And even then, you may not know what you're doing or how you're doing. And those are just your sankalpas, your karma's working out. And that's just the way that it is. Hey, I'm okay. You're okay. Ka-ching. It's all good. Well, I think it was the anchovies, actually, General. In fact, I'm almost sure it was. First of all, I shouldn't have been eating pizza this late in the day, for one thing. You know, it always gives me heartburn. And then I add on the anchovies on top of that. And there's no question at all this is what's causing it. Well, I'm an idiot. What am I thinking? You know, it's just like, it's ridiculous. Well, what I think, generally, is that actually you just got hacked. I just found out about this just a little while ago, that all your personal information has been compromised. And I want to assure you, all precautions were taken, but this is a very sophisticated operation that took place, and we're not sure, you know, to what extent you've been compromised, but we're on it. We're trying to fix the security breach, and we're trying to, you know, assess, going through a protocol, assessing just exactly how much, how badly you were compromised, and we're going to be in touch with you, and work with you through this, help you get through this, make sure that, you know, there isn't, you know, some activity on your accounts, various accounts, etc., like that, and make sure that there's nothing unusual taking place there, and we're going to get to the bottom of this, I assure you. I also want to apologize to you personally for any inconvenience this might be causing you, and I hope that we look forward to serving you in the future. What do I think, General? I think we're going to Disneyland. Yeah, baby. Woo! Well, General, I don't often say this, actually, especially with people I don't know well. But I sort of feel kind of a bond with you. I feel like I can tell you this. When I was a lot younger, actually pretty young, I'm not exactly sure how to say this to you, but I had what I would say was a life-changing experience. I had a life-changing experience, and I kind of feel like I've just had another life-changing experience. Yeah, it's just I hope you don't mind me telling you this. Well, General, I got a level with you. I'm gonna try to get this on the front page. I'll do my best, and I think I can get it done, but I can't promise you it's gonna be the headline, because I gotta work with my editor, you know, and ultimately I've gotta work with the publisher. And to be perfectly honest with you, I don't exactly have, you know, absolute pull. I don't got anything on them. I can't say, you know, it's like, hey, you do this for me, or cause I'll do a favor for you. You know, they're going to do what they're going to do. So I cannot promise you, can't promise it to you. But I promise you, I'm going to try. I'm going to try my best. Okay? Beautiful. You know, General, what I'm seeing right here, right now, is a mini-series. It's perfect. And you know who I'm going to cast as you, don't you? Yeah. You already know. My gosh, it's just like, it's producing itself right in front of our eyes. It's fantastic. General, if I ever see you pull another prank like this, I'm gonna report you. Is that understood? General, I kinda hate to tell you this, but this is actually an archaeological site that you've just desecrated. And there's gonna be a whole lot of people that aren't very happy about that. And you're gonna be hearing from them real soon. You do know, General, that you're on private property, and I'm gonna have to ask you to leave right now. I just want to know what's on your playlist, General. I mean I listen to Archie Bell McGrills. Hey everybody, I'm Archie Bell McGrills, and we're gonna do something called the Tighten Up. Cut, that's a wrap. Very good job, people. Very good.